soon after I became chief of staff, I think it was like a 2 o'clock or almost 2:30 phone call that I got. And you know, when you get those phone calls, it's never good news. So I picked up the phone, and it was a Secret Service agent who said, Mr. Panetta, I'm sorry to wake you, but I have to tell you that a plane went into the White House. I said, holy cow. What was it? I said, was it a 747 or, you know, or what kind of plane was this? And he said, no, it's a small plane. Went up against the White House, hit the Jackson Magnolia tree. We think everything's okay. And I said, well, wait a minute. I said, was this a terrorist attack on the White House? Have you gone out to the plane? You know, have you seen whether there are explosives in the plane? And there was a pause. And the guy said, well, according to CNN News. I said, excuse me. I said, I want you to go out there, look at that plane, and tell me what the hell is there. Now, what that basically means is that, you know, you've got to continue to push people in their jobs to do the right thing. It's not enough to kind of assume that they're going to do it. And I think particularly in the second term, there is, you kind of take things for granted. People don't pay attention to the details that they need to pay attention to. And that really requires tough supervision to make sure, particularly with the Secret Service, that they're always at the top of their game. You cannot just sit back and assume that that's the case. You got to basically push people to make sure they're doing the right thing. And particularly where it involves the life of the president and the first family, you do not mess around with that. You make damn sure that they know what they're doing.
Do you think that's what's happened?
I think they got a little bit casual about protecting the president of the United States, and I don't think you can afford to let that happen.